I was born Jonathan Aaron Steele. To the parents of William and Elizabeth Steele, I am a Leo, born under the sign of the lion. And I was raised in a lower middle class family with only one brother, Michael, whom I loved dearly. Told me when I was born, an angel flew over my bed and christened me with a magic wand and said, "You shall be the one."
I was a boy on Wall Street, a prisoner.
brother Michael, the one person who was my guiding light, my friend, my hero, was killed by a drunk driver in a head-on collision. He died instantly. I couldn't even bring myself to go to his funeral. My agony was so great, I just couldn't come face to face with him that one last time. For 1 year after his death, I roamed the streets in a fog, barely conscious of anything or anyone. I discovered alcohol and girls, drugs, and in general, a life I had never known, which was exciting, frightening, and wonderfully dangerous.
Go forever. I was waiting for my
lived and struggled in the arena for 2 years, trying to get a break in the music world and make a record. And that's when I ran across a delightful businessman named Charlie. He was the president of one of the biggest record companies in the world. The music business to Charlie was nothing more than a sacrificial lamb to be led to slaughter. And the weapon of choice was his record company that he'd wield like a mighty sword. The great tool he would lovingly refer to as the chainsaw. gypsy woman passed by. She stopped and asked me if I'd like to have my fortune read. I'd never had it done, so I was more than happy to say yes. She revealed a deck of tarot cards and began to tell me of my past, my brother, and my parents. She saw my present, with my great struggle to succeed, fulfillment of my dreams and newfound happiness. I wanted to know of my future and pleaded with her to go on. Himself as the doctor. I asked him, what kind of doctor? he smiled and said, "Meet my friend, Uncle Slam."
Call, stop smoking, rolling up and down my blood.
thing that would have meant more to me than anything. The pain that manifested itself into my obsession. The acceptance of me by my mother and father, who I had not spoken to since I had left home.
One morning,
my manager Alex
came,
and he threatened to leave me if I didn't clean up. It was not that he cared about me as a person. He was only interested in my talent and what it could do to further his own career as a true showbiz mogul. But it was then I realized just how far things had gone. So I sat there, alone, in my palace of pain, and I had just enough courage to pick up the phone and dial the number. The voice at the other end rang out, and it sent a chill through me that I'd never known. It was my mother. It was hard for me to speak. My heart was pounding out of my chest. But when I did the best I could. Less than 50 words were spoken. Some wounds never heal. Mine has scarred me for life. Great star fell from the sky that night, and with its descent left a scorched path in its way. A great path of self-destruction before burning out.
Thank you. got there, I looked around. There was nothing there.
Take my home. I was doing some interviews earlier today, and they said that tonight is the last night of this European tour, and I said, yes, it is. And they said, well, why have you chosen Moscow so many times to close? And I said, because the love that we get from these people, this is the only place we want to close. So we go home tomorrow, but I know you guys ain't ready to go home right now, are you? Well, we got one more thing to say before we go. 'Cause I wanna be somebody.